till I drink.
I swear, I say, I will always be safe. I will wash my hands with soap and water. Mama and Papa, please fill our toilet. The bar we get it red in our hands.
Yes, I sure, yes.
That's the secret to my hair.
I will never toilet in open place. I use in latrine.
I swear, I say, I will always be safe. I will wash my hands with soap and water. Mama and Papa, please fill our toilet. The bar we get it red in our hands.
Yes, I sure, yes. Yes, I sure, yes.
The secret to my hair.
I will never toilet in open place. I will wash my hands before eating my food. I will wash my hands after using latrine.
My name is Dr. Clarence Moneybone, and I head the President's Agenda Unit. And in our unit, we focus on priority projects for the President. And that's why we're here this morning, because this is a priority. Getting washed in schools is a priority not only for the president, not only for schools, not only for this nation, but our apartments as well. So that's why we're here. Throughout this Ebola fight, there's been a lot of bad, but there's also been a lot of good. Some of the good is that now we're less than 2 weeks away from being declared Ebola free, led by President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf. Is that we were able to take stock of what this administration has done concerning wash facilities. And we realized that we've built thousands of wash facilities, not only in schools, but in the communities as well. Now, if we were to look at the bad, we then realized that we've still fallen short in the amount of wash facilities that we need in schools. Our numbers indicate that we should have 35 girls to every latrine, 50 boys for every latrine. Currently, we have at least 120 students for every single latrine. And that's why we're here today, to change this number so that we can achieve and we can get to not only 100% wash in schools, but to the 35 girls per latrine, 50 boys per latrine. With that being said, I'm going to call up Emmanuel Keeman from Equip Liberia to give us the invitation.
When Israel was going through a very terrible time in the wilderness, facing a lot of development challenges, ranging from spiritual to social, with all sorts of gaps, including health crisis, God had is to say for them, serve the Lord your God, and he will bless your bread and your water, and I will take sickness from your land. As we face the health challenges in our country, let's depend on God protect away sickness from our land and bless our water, and to wash our hands for clean water and soap in our schools, in our communities, at our workplaces, and in our homes. Let's pray. Dear Lord, we thank you for this movement in our nation's history. We commit this situation to your hands, and we thank you for the level of improvement you have brought to our country. As we come to launch another event, another milestone, another situation that we want to see happen in our country, we pray, oh God, that you will bless our country. You will bless the waters of our land, Lord, that you will take sickness from our country. Thank you, oh God, for your love. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen.
Call up Principal Augustus Siyonga, who will lead us on the national anthem, as well as provide us welcome statements.
We all rise for the national anthem, please. Oh, hill, Liberia, hill, oh, hill, oh, hill.
Heads of NGOs, faculty of this noble institution, Assembly King, distinguished guests, students, ladies and gentlemen. As a way of welcoming you, I'd like to firstly give you a testimony to me of what is today in CBK Elementary School. The CBK Elementary School was established in 1952 by President William B. Stockman, and was named in honor of President Charles Dunbar Bodges King, the 17th President of Liberia. Today, as principal of the school, we are pleased to be part of those that are promoting the issue of hand wash and wash in the nation as a whole. Not before you with this long discussion, long speech, I'd like to use this time now to say you all are welcome. And thank you.
Some of our dignitaries who are up on stage with us. Of course, we have the ambassador of the European Union, Oxfam, Minister of Health, Minister of Public Works, Minister of Education, UNICEF, the African Development Bank, Minister of Youth and Sports, our WASH Consortium, and partners of the National Water Sanitation and Hygiene Promotion Committee.
Government officials, your president, our partners, distinguished platform guests, distinguished invited guests, students of Sydney King School, ladies and gentlemen. The Ministry of Health and Social Welfare is very pleased to participate in this very important launching program in our schools, our president, to emphasize the importance of WASH activities in our schools. Child survival is very critical to nation building. Before the Ebola crisis, Liberia was among about 6 or 7 nations that were on track to achieving MDG 4. Our country has made significant gains in the area of child survival. When the Ebola crisis struck, a lot of things changed in our settings, especially in the communities, in the schools, and in our health facilities. Before the opening or reopening of our schools, the Ministry of Health recognizing the importance of WASH activities in school in order to control or prevent Ebola in the schools, closely work with the Ministry of Education to ensure that the teachers were trained all around this country. And as we speak, most of our teachers from all of the districts in 15 counties were trained in collaboration with the Ministry of Education. And today we are very pleased for that our ongoing collaboration, which will continue as we recover from the Ebola crisis. As a means of supporting WASH activities in the school, because of its importance, the Ministry of Health continues to work with the Ministry of Education to ensure that all of the essential supplies needed or required to ensure that the students wash their hands are being provided. We continue to collaborate even before the crisis with the establishment of a school health program, which is between the Ministry of Education and the Ministry of Health. This collaboration existed before the crisis, and our aim is to strengthen that collaboration beyond WASH activities, but to include reproductive health, to include deworming, to include ensuring that children are checked properly to see whether they have hearing problem or they have vision problem. So we'll continue to emphasize not only WASH activities, but other activities to ensure the well-being of the students as they go through their education program. We also want to emphasize that with support from our partners, UNICEF and the Islamic Development Bank, the Ministry of Education and Health will continue to work closely with all of the schools around our country to closely monitor WASH activities. It is significant to launch this, but ensuring that we make this an integral part of our institution is very critical. Let me say that in a recent assessment, knowledge, attitude, and practice assessment conducted along with UNICEF shows that 98% of those interviewed, a total of 1,100 respondents, have changed one or more behavior as a result of the Ebola crisis. Among these, 83% have changed their behavior mainly in the area of hand washing. So as the president launched this occasion today in this school, it is our hope that we will continue to wash our hands both in the schools, in our communities, to ensure that we do not only prevent Ebola, but also waterborne diseases which has plagued us in the past, the cholera and other diseases that are waterborne. On behalf of the Ministry of Health, we want to say that the Ministry of Health will continue to collaborate closely with the Ministry of Education to ensure a safe school environment for our students, and to ensure that we sustain the game even after Liberia is declared Ebola free. Thank you.
Next up, I'd like to call Minister Judy Moore, who will be discussing improving access to water and sanitation facilities for schools.
Madam President, colleagues, partners, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, students, we're very happy to be here today. Very, very happy that we're launching our Washington Schools. One of the things that we're going to focus on at the Ministry of Public Works is to increase access in our schools. As we travel along the way from Monrovia going to the rural parts of the country, for schools that are found close to the road, you see some wash facilities. But once you get past the main roads and start to go inside, you see that most of the schools that are there lack even the most basic facilities. So for us this year, one of the things we're going to do is try to improve and increase access to Washington schools. And with this, we're going to work as closely as possible, as we've been doing, but even more closely with our partners in the sector. And so this year, in terms of the work plan at the Ministry of Public Works, WASH is going to be reflected in the budget as it hasn't been in previous years. We're very confident that working with the President and the Ministry of Finance, we will be able to get commitment for WASH and for the sector. But thank you. However, just before we got here today, we were briefed a little bit about the condition of WASH in our schools. And we simply did a sampling of schools in Monrovia, schools within 20 minutes drive of the Ministry of Public Works, where the WASH condition is so appalling that in some instances, sending your children to school is like sending your children to get sick. There are schools where they have a small room in the back with plastic buckets, plastic bags in them, where the kids go relieve themselves, cover it, go back to class, and supposedly at the end of the school day, somebody comes and picks it up. But that's even in the places where they have facilities. There are places where they have absolutely no facility at all. And these are schools in Monrovia, which frightens me when you think about schools outside Monrovia. So in terms of expanding WASH facility, we are going to work with our partners at the Ministry of Health, at the Ministry of Education, to be slightly more aggressive in terms of our enforcement. Similarly, if you run a restaurant and the health inspectors come and the sanitary conditions are not good, they shut down that restaurant. We cannot have schools where we send our children to get sick. And so in instances where a school is not keeping up with the WASH conditions, it will be our position at the Ministry of Public Works to shut that school down until those conditions can be fixed. We're looking to work with our partners in the NGO sector and work with our colleagues at the Ministry of Health, the Ministry of Education, but WASH access, expanding access, and improving the quality of that access is what the Ministry of Public Works is going to focus on. So thank you very much for being here today.
Minister of Education to speak about the statement of purpose of presentation of WASH wings in school.
Madam President, our partners in progress, my colleagues, and all of you who have come here today because of your hard work to just give a feeling of expression of needs of the schools in our country. You've done so much, and now WASH is on the high part of our needs. I want to thank you for coming just for this luncheon today. The Ministry of Education has remained committed to the fight against Ebola. During the Ebola outbreak, we were fully engaged in training 6,800 school administrators and teachers to conduct Ebola prevention awareness in all communities. Prior to the resumption of academic activities, a protocol was developed to ensure the safe reopening of schools. With support from our partners, supplies including buckets, thermal flash boots, soap, chlorine, and other essential hygiene material were distributed to public and private schools. We have continued post-Ebola recovery activities to the development of a protocol for WASH in the schools.
Sure.
The protocol contains guidelines to ensure the implementation of water, sanitation, and hygiene in schools. This initiative is a result of effective collaboration between the Ministries of Education, Health, Public Works, and our partners. We encourage all education stakeholders, including education officers, principals, teachers, parents, communities, and students, to adhere to the protocols to ensure a safe, healthy, and conducive school environment. Without the involvement and efforts of everyone, we will remain unlikely to achieve the target results. We look forward to continued support from our partners to improve the condition of WASH at school, but we also look forward to the initiative of principals, teachers, and parents to continue the process. Let us all work together to ensure a clean, safe, and healthy, and conducive environment in schools, communities, and in Liberia. I know that we have all set together our partners, and we have developed this. This was done hastily to a large extent, because we wanted to get something out for schools that were open. I know we'll have to review it again and look at some of the things that were left out, or some things that are included that should have not been there, and so we can have something that schools can work with. And our principals and teachers, you are the ones who are depending on to do this. The partners have done their share. The ministries are doing their share. And we all need to collaborate and get it done properly. And this is the protocol that we all have. Thank you.
Next, I'd like to call up some of our government partners. First, UNICEF, Mr. Summerlee.
Madam President, ministers, representatives of government, ambassadors, students, all protocols observed. As UNICEF, we are extremely proud to be with you today to launch these protocols. We know that during the darkest days of the Ebola epidemic, how important it was for hygiene to be in place, for people to have facilities to wash their hands. We know that communities took matters in their own hands. We know that on street corners, we know that in rural areas, there are buckets in place, hand washing facilities in place, and behaviors were changed. But we also know for these changes in behavior to be sustainable, more infrastructure needs to be in place, particularly in schools. We know from the assessment that was done by the WASH Consortium and UNICEF that 55% of schools in Liberia do not have access to functional water supply. We know that 43% of schools do not have access to functional latrines. And we know that over 80% of schools do not have access to hand washing facilities. Ladies and gentlemen, all of us want all children in Liberia to go to school and to stay in school and to learn in school. We particularly want girls to stay in school. And we know from our work around the world that it's absolutely essential that sanitation facilities be in place in school for girls to stay in schools. We look forward to working with our partners and the leadership of the government of Liberia to ensure the statistics go up, to ensure that all children go to school and stay in school. Thank you very much.
Next, I'd like to call up Representative Oxfam in the Washington Consortium. I'd like to call up Mr. Drake Chiyan.
Your Excellency, Madam President, Honorable Minister, President, members of the diplomatic group, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, all protocols out. Madam President, I have 2 points to make. I work with the WASH Consortium, but I'll take a risk to say that I'm representing the NGO sector on WASH. And I deliver two messages from the NGO sector. Madam President, right now, the people you see here, most